step, and now you're new here. Pitchers, go and get ready. Numbers 1 through 10, let's go. Let's get after it.
So we wait. A second hat to sweat through. It's already dripping inside my glasses.
Need me to bring you some water or something?
I got water in the dugout. I'm gonna go get some.
So how do you feel?
Well, my heart's in my throat. There's so much good talent out here, and then there's me. But there's some neat guys out here.
I asked one of the pitchers trying out how he felt. He said, "Well, I haven't thrown a ball in a long time."
Oh gosh, yeah. Yeah, I was visiting with one of the guys who signed up last night at like 8 o'clock. I was like, man, if I waited till then, I don't think I would have signed up.
Nice and
you?
No bobbles.
Yeah, and then I follow the two guys with the cannons for arms. Whew. It's like, cannon, old man.
I couldn't see your throws. I was focused on the screen.
Well, I think they at least got to the places where they were supposed to go eventually.
Eventually.
Yeah, you know, kind of like skipping stones across the lake. Across the lake.
You can be faster, you can be accurate. Accurate's better.
Yeah, except these guys can run, too.
What's next?
Infield. A couple grounders infield, then batting practice. So, getting ready for ground.
Look pretty good. No bobbles.
They're fast.
Thank you. Very much.
All right. Let's see you walk through the gate for the first time. I'm coming with you.
Who was your teacher last year?
Yeah, it's like, no, we live.
That's who Luke had. Luke had Miss Bell.
New York City. So it was a player guy.
Excited to have you guys. Tony does an awesome job. He puts a ton of effort into this thing, as you can tell. He puts a ton of passion into it as well. And I played with a lot of you guys over the course of the last 3 years. I know a handful of you guys. I know some of you guys have played with some other teams. And I coach at Drury. So what I tell our guys at all times at Drury, which is pretty much my same rules for you guys, is one, you got to be a good person. And I drafted the team, for the most part, of guys that I knew, guys that I played with, guys that I've coached before, that I think are going to do the right things on and off the field. And if you don't do that, primarily, then I don't need you on the team. And there's guys in this league that, or that were in the leagues in the past, teams in the past, that I don't need you on the team. I'm going to dedicate my Sundays. You guys are going to dedicate your Sundays to have some fun. Like, it's not fun to be around guys that are going to be so high strung, whether I get out or whether I'm safe, whether I'm out. Mouthing umpires and so worried about wins and losses, like, that's not any fun. Like, we're out here to have a blast for hopefully 9 weeks, right? You're not signed up for 7 weeks, you're signed up for 9 weeks. And so make sure that we conduct ourselves in the dugout with the umpires who get paid dirt for, right? We don't need to mouth any umpires. Like, they're gonna make terrible calls, I can guarantee you that. Like, especially week three or four, they're free umpires. They will be terrible. They'll be guys trying to get into high school. That's how it is. They're trying to get into high school. Okay? They don't know the rules. Like, they're calling infield flies on two strikes and two outs. They did it on us 2 years ago. Okay? But I expect you guys to conduct yourselves accordingly. Because last year we played against a team that I feel like they didn't. And I'm not going to be surrounding myself with that. Okay? Two, you got to be a good student. I don't give a shit if you guys are good students anymore. Like, I don't need you guys to get into university, so we can skip that rule.
Number 10.
Cyclone.